How do you know the tea in your cup is what it claims to be?
People have a lot of trust that what it says on the label is actually what's inside the packet.
I'm here at the famous Queen's University in Belfast, involved in something truly groundbreaking, tea fingerprinting.
Many years ago, you had the horsemeat scandal. You can see oregano being adulterated with olive leaves. You buy the food and you expect it to be genuine. You expect it to be authentic.
Researchers at Queen's University are using AI technology to identify specific markers on each tea so you can be sure what tea it is, where it comes from.
We can say this has come from a deforested area.
Or in fact, if it's actually tea at all.
But in reality, they receive something that nobody knows what it really is.
Are there people out there who are cheating the system?
Someone's just making up a tea-like drink or product by using rice husk, colorants, and flavorers.
In the heart of the historic Northern Irish city of Belfast sits Queen's University, a world-leading institution in its own right, but particularly known for its work on food safety. Spearheading the subject within the Biological Science Department is Professor Christopher Elliott, who we, myself and other tea experts at the European Speciality Tea Association came to visit today.
I probably became best known for the authenticity work around the horsemeat scandal in the UK in 2013.
This was the international story from 2013 about how horse meat was found in beef burgers and other beef products across UK supermarkets.
Officials in the UK are conceding they may never know exactly how many people have unwittingly eaten
horse meat, masquerading as beef in some Findus lasagnas.
There's no reason to believe that any frozen food currently on sale is unsafe or a danger to health.
Northwest English county of Lancashire, 47 different schools admitted that the cottage pies they'd been serving students had horse, all now withdrawn.
Food fraud is a very complex subject. Often the public will be quite happy to go into small stores, supermarkets, cafes, restaurants. You buy the food and you expect it to be genuine, you expect it to be authentic. Unfortunately, quite often that's not the case, because people will be setting out to make money out of fraudulent practices.
As the university wasn't set up to do routine testing, they had to set up a spin-off company called Beer Analytical.
Well, what the company does is we develop tests for food authenticity, safety, and quality. Am I getting the tea that I've paid the money for, or am I getting something that's inferior?
But why, of all things, are the university focusing on tea?
Tea as the most well-traded beverage in the world and most popular beverage in the world, there's a huge potential of the supply chain being conducted and suffered from the vulnerability and challenges of food fraud.
Tea is actually part of our society. It's a really important thing that we do. We drink tea.
In fact, the UK ranks third when it comes to per capita consumption of tea in the world.
Would you ever think that the tea that you're buying, some form of cheating has gone on? No, because nobody is really looking at it terribly carefully. And that's what we decided to do, really to do a deep dive into tea fraud, find out, is it happening, and then try to stop it.
So into the lab to see how this works.
This laboratory is designated by the UK government as a centre of excellence in food authenticity. We have researchers from all over the world come to work here. More than 50 different ways we can measure things in this lab, okay?
When it comes to speciality tea is high value. And wherever there is high value in anything, there is always room for fraud. A good example is Darjeeling, where a lot more Darjeeling is sold than produced. There are other high-value teas, you know, matcha, white tea, some special oolongs, where this happens as well. So it is a risk to those who are looking to buy and sell very high-value teas.
People are being cheated, but there's also a lot of safety issues as well. Because if somebody is tampering with a food product, adulterating it, you've absolutely no idea what they're adulterating it with. And often we have come across terrible stories and terrible examples of where people have added stuff to food which is unsafe. We really do this concept of what we call food fingerprinting. We will produce a molecular fingerprint of every type of foodstuff. I think we're all familiar with the concept of fingerprints, been used in forensic science for a very long period of time. What we did is we have adopted a form of fingerprinting, except our fingerprinting is based on molecules that actually make up tea. There's probably 50,000 different molecules in tea. There is a huge, there's thousands of different compounds, chemicals in your tea, which gives it the flavor, the aroma. And what we do is we measure all of those molecules and we produce a fingerprint for a particular variety of tea. Once we develop that fingerprint, it's impossible to cheat. Anybody who tries to sell a tea that hasn't got that fingerprint, we will identify really quickly. And what we can do is we can inject tea sample into some of our machines, okay? It will get hit with this massive wave of electrons. It will fragment into 50,000 different pieces, and we can measure each and every one of those, okay? And from that becomes the world's most elaborate jigsaw puzzle. And that fingerprint is unique.
Chris Elliott called it the Star Trek laboratory. It really is a Star Trek laboratory. Those machines are amazing.
This is actually a robot which is attached to this, and then there is a laser, a small laser there, which means we can automate this system. So instead of only being able to test maybe 50 or 100 samples per day, we can actually generate thousands of samples. Can you guarantee that that tea, for instance, has come through sustainable supply chains? Can you tell that that tea is not involved in some way in modern day slavery or child labor? And what we set out to do is make sure the tea that we're all drinking and enjoying is authentic, safe, transparent, and coming from sustainable sources.
So what exactly are we looking for when it comes to fraud? What are we talking about here today?
So I think nowadays that the most well-known adulteration in the tea industry is about mislabeling or misclaiming of the geographical indications.
So we call this part of the lab, we call this Element Alley. Here, what we do is we measure the elemental composition of samples, okay? It's the soil that they're grown in. That will determine what elements are inside.
When we're looking at one of the features of authenticity is often, where was this grown, where was it produced? And using our fingerprinting technology, we can say, what continent did it come from? That's, I have to tell you, pretty easy stuff.
Then we can go down to, what country does it come from? That's also relatively easy.
But we can go further. We can actually go down to the region of the country. Did it come from the north? Did it come from the south? Did it come from a hilly area? Did it come from lowland? All based on these fingerprints.
For instance, our work in Brazil, we've got six different regions. We're getting soil samples from Brazil so that we can say, yes, it came from Brazil, but it does not come from one of the areas which is linked to deforestation. Or we can say, this has come from a deforested area. So you can get really, really very, very accurate information about the elemental profiles of these.
So we can really pinpoint it, actually sometimes down to the factory it was processed in based on the fingerprint.
And what is AI's role in tea fingerprinting?
This is a great example of how we are exploiting artificial intelligence in terms of developing these fingerprints. Because what we are doing is we are actually using a form of AI called machine learning. And when our computer, our software, sees a particular fingerprint, then that can identify it as a particular variety of tea. And the more samples that we analyze, the more data that we put into our machine learning program, and the more accurate, the more reliable it becomes. So it really is a machine learning the fingerprint. And from that, the analysis becomes much more reliable.
As speciality tea gains popularity, knowing where your tea comes from and what you're paying for becomes more important than ever.
So our aim as a company is to help support the tea industry, not to be a stick to beat them, but to be someone to help support in the claims that they're making.
I think it's important to make clear that tea fraud goes way beyond just the quality issue. Everyone suffers if tea is adulterated or if tea is sold as a product that it's not, because the people who grow the tea, who harvest the tea, who process the tea, their communities suffer. So I think tea fraud is at the heart of actually our commitment to the tea growing communities of the world.
I'm really excited about this project, and I'm very pleased to be part of this project, because the whole issue about quality, assurance, transparency is something that I really strongly believe in. It is at the heart of speciality tea. All these things we do is in order to give the consumer what they want, and the consumers want this.
Tea fingerprinting empowers us to make informed choices. It ensures that the tea in your cup is exactly what it claims to be, authentic, high quality, and true to its roots. So as you enjoy your next cup of tea, remember, understanding its story isn't just important, it's essential. Tea is more than a drink, it's a journey. And now with tea fingerprinting, it's a journey you can trace with confidence. To follow more on this story for news, tea, adventures, and recipes, subscribe to my channel, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.